Hey guys, right here I have a 2011 Nissan X-Trail. And today, I'm gonna make a startup and full vehicle tour video of it. Show you the features, inside and out. So, here's the key fob. Let's go ahead and start it up first. This car does come with Nissan's version of a keyless entry and start system, so just have the key fob on yourself. The doors are currently unlocked. Press this black button to lock it. And to unlock it, press the black button again. This car does have keyless start, so once the key fob is inside the car, twist this knob right here. This car has 17,763 kilometers.
Spot grips on the side.
This car comes with Nissan's Xtronic Continuously Variable Transmission, otherwise known as CVT. Essentially what it is that it's an automatic transmission with an infinite number of gear ratios that allows you to maximize fuel efficiency while driving and also have a smoother drive. You also have manual shifting via the plus and minus right here. Alright, so let's go ahead and turn on the hazards, lights, fog lights. Take a look at the engine. And this car has an automatic driver's side window. Indicators on the front fenders. ...16-inch alloy rims with Bridgestone tires.
Auto leveling by xenon headlights with a projector lens. This car also comes with the headlight washer system, as well as front fog lights. This car comes with a 2-litre dual overhead cam 16-valve inline 4 with Nissan's continuously variable valve timing control system. The engine produces 139 horsepower at 5200 rpm and 198 Nm of torque at 4400 rpm. The car itself is front-wheel drive.
vertical rear lights, rear spoiler, with your third brake light, rear parking sensors, that's the keyless access button to release your rear hatch, or rather to unlock the rear hatch. Your reverse lights and a single rear exhaust. Speaker, cup holder, storage area, window controls, window lock, central locking, mirror controls, left, neutral, right. Cup holder, button to activate your headlight washers, X-Trail floor mats, driver seat in this car is powered. This is for your seat back. This is for your seat position, seat height, alright. So let's go ahead and see how she rests. Aircon controls, fan speed, temperature, your different modes, front defrost is right here, rear defrost, recirculation, air conditioning, right down here you have your power outlet, storage area, got your 6 customizable stations, CD player, auxiliary SD card slot to change between your different FM AM preset stations, auxiliary USB, CD, central storage, light and indicator controls, wiper controls. The steering wheel in this car is tilt only, you adjust it using this lever right here. And you also have a multi-information display in the instrument cluster, adjusted using this button right here. Right here you have trip A, trip B, range, average fuel consumption, average speed, your elapsed time, as well as an outside temperature and time as well. However, you do not get steering wheel audio controls or cruise control on this car. Storage areas above and below the radio. Cup holders. Central storage. Alright. So that's it for the startup. We can turn it off right now. And continue with the rest of the tour. Speaker, storage area, window control. Seats do fold. Just move the seat base forward. Then, pull this lever to move the seat back down. You need the headrest removed in order to fold it completely. But you get roughly the idea on how to get it folded down. You can also adjust the angle of the backrest. Just pull the same lever. Storage buckets on the seat backs, rear aircon vents. You also have manual lumbar for the driver's seat. Cup holders. Storage. Hook. There's a button right beneath the Nissan badge that opens up the rear hatch. And the car has a pretty low load height, so you don't really have to stretch too much to carry the items to be filled into the boot. Storage trays. You can also pull this up. And cargo cover. You also have individual cargo covers to attach to the headrest. You also have hooks on the side, storage areas on the side. That's your jack. Power outlet. And another hook right there. Front passenger seat is powered as well, just that you don't have the height adjustment, which means this is for your seat back and your seat position. The front passenger seat also does not have the lumbar support. Lockable glove box, it's pretty big as well. USB port, cup holder, Alright, so let's start it up with the door closed. Alright, so that's it for the startup and full vehicle tour video of this 2011 Nissan X-Trail. Thanks for watching and goodbye.